Hey there, I'm Jake with FlashCut CNC. Today, I'm going to walk you through the pain-free process of upgrading your Torchmate plasma table with the latest and greatest in FlashCut controls. You may be wondering what sort of benefits you can expect to see. And now, I know you don't have all day, so I'm just going to hit the highlights. The most noticeable advantage is our integrated torch height control system. With this system, the table will now be able to do full Z-axis motion, and the operator will have access to all of the torch height controls right on the computer screen. Additionally, we've taken all of the major torch manufacturers' cut charts and integrated them into the software. Now, this eliminates the need for the operator to manually enter this data. Speaking of our software, each of our controls ships with compatibility for our CAD, CAM, and CNC software. This fully integrated all-in-one program allows you to design and cut without having to switch from one platform to another. Now, you may have noticed that I'm using one word a lot, and that's integrated. That's because our controls have been designed to work in as one single unit instead of several separate control systems trying to work together. Now, there's one last and maybe less obvious benefit to an upgrade, and that's that every FlashCut system comes with the best support in the industry, and it's all provided by our technicians here at our Chicago headquarters. That's the level of confidence that we have in our controls. We like to live up to our motto, control made simple. And so, it's easy enough for anyone to get new life out of their Torchmate table with a FlashCut retrofit. With that out of the way, let's take a look at your controls and see what vintage they are. Your controls will look like one of these units, but we're most interested in the hookups at the rear of the system. Go ahead and take a look, and then we can determine what exactly you have. These older double box systems are prime candidates for upgrade. You'll have either a 401 serial or 501 USB signal generator unit, as well as a larger drive box.
An upgrade from these two box systems will have more power and precision through higher amperage and microstepping technology. In fact, many retrofitters choose to upgrade to the 8-amp Pro series, which includes both anti-resonance as well as inertia matching to improve motion even further.
Next, let's take a look at the back of the 2.5-amp compact controller. First, check the left-hand side and see if the expansion cutout is present. You'll also want to make note of whether you have 3 or 4 axes. Last, we have the 8-amp Pro Series. The distinguishing feature here is the motor connector. If your system uses the circular XLR connectors, it's easy to count the number of axes you have. However, on the older MiniFit units, you'll have to look inside the fourth connector to see if pins are present. If they are, your controller is already set with 4 axes. We'll start off by upgrading the controller. For this install, I have a Pro Series with the old MiniFit connectors. Our first step is to take the lid off. There are 3 goals of this upgrade. 1. To replace the old backplate with a compatible version. 2. To add a 4th axis for lifter control. And 3, install a mini I/O expansion board. With just a couple of screws and a couple of plugs, our system is up to date and ready to handle both full 3-dimensional range of motion and torch height control. The compact series will come in one of 2 flavors, one of which does not have an I/O slot cut out, the other of which already does. Now, in the case that you have one of the older vintage models, you'll either need a chassis from us, or you have the option of sending it in for replacement here at our facility. In the case of the newer models, all that's needed is the addition of an extra drive card and an I/O board for the THC control.
Upgrading the compact is as simple as swapping this old board and cabling out for the new. mounting a new drive card on the signal generator board.
Now that the controller part of the upgrade is out of the way, it's time to look at lifters. Now, the old Torchmate lifter, the minimum requirement is to swap out the motor for a compatible one with our system, as well as upgrade the cabling. Now, most users will choose to upgrade to our lifter, which features a longer length of travel, enabling a lower mounting point on the torch. This eliminates torch wobble. This lifter also has a robust collision breakaway system, as well as several built-in limit switches for both homing and backup plate detection.
Our lifter was designed with compatibility in mind. The bolt hole slots fit a Torchmate carriage as well as a variety of other tables.
In comparison to the old Torchmate control system, FlashCut's torch height control is slimmed down, simplified, and integrated. As I mentioned earlier, your controls move from the unit itself onto the screen right in front of the operator. Each of these cable connections is unique to its correct position. And at the end of the torch height control system, we have a standard machine interface CPC connector. Now, you'll want to double check your torch power supply and make sure that you have divided arc voltage coming out of it instead of raw arc voltage that the old system used.
When you look at your circular torch interface connector, you should notice four pins in a sort of bent L shape near the top. Then, on the bottom row, you'll see either one or three pins. If all three pins aren't present, you'll need to acquire a 50-to-1 voltage divider card from the torch manufacturer. Our controls will allow for a truly controllable live Z axis. Our THC also comes ready for ohmic plate sensing, which is a significant upgrade from a simple pressure sense. An ohmic system will find the material more accurately and eliminate the potential to deform the plate. Loading the cut charts is as easy as selecting your material and consumables. As you can see, we've included a long list of torch models to choose from.
Many of the Torchmate tables came equipped with these smaller NEMA 23 motors. We recommend an upgrade to our NEMA 2303, which is going to be a stronger motor, giving you faster table speeds and a more consistent cut. The other advantage of this motor is a heavier duty industrialized connection with 18 gauge cable as opposed to the standard 22 gauge cable on those smaller motors. These upgraded motors will fit the same mounting points as the old motors, as well as have the same shaft diameter for coupling. All right, now that we've covered everything from controls to motors, I hope that you have a better understanding of what it's going to take to retrofit your Torchmate plasma table. For more information, or if you're ready to place an order, contact your local distributor. Thank you so much for watching.